obesity, and this is a fast class. We don't move necessarily fast, but we move functionally. So, lots of strength work? No worry, not really. Good. Oh, I love to get those shoulders, open that upper body up. First thing, nice and early. All right, let's go, a little more. Three, two, all right, let's stick with those squats. Squats, good. Little lower body wake up. Good, good. Yes. All right, let's add to this. How about a squat and a rotate? Nothing crazy. Good. Up, squat. Rotate, just slightly. Good. We're gonna keep squatting. We're gonna squat, back, squat, back, squat, back. Good, from the side, we kick slightly back. So in terms of where your position is, good. Squat, 4 o'clock, 8 o'clock. Good.
Good, let's go the other way. Never gonna be ready to move, they say.
strength work. Good. But I'm going to work kind of in groupings. So, and some of it will be timed. This one, I love that your fan just came off the shelf. Good. Good. Reach. I can't turn the fans on here. Woo! All right. 30 seconds. I want to see that lunge long. Okay, truth is I can't see anything. Good. My hope is that you've got a nice long lunge. And who lost you? Good. Reach. Yep. Good. 5 seconds. 4, 3, 2, and 1. That's your warm-up on that leg. We'll keep going. All right, I'm going to have you grab your 8s. If you want to do 5s, that's fine to start. We're going to do some lateral raises with some deadlifts. I'll turn sideways slightly. Weights on the floor to start. I want you to practice that deadlift. It is a split stance deadlift. The split stance makes your hips stretch further. So this is a little more intense than if you were doing your regular deadlift just standing. That split stance adds a good 30 to 45 degrees of stretch. Good, so be careful with it. I don't expect you to reach all the way down your weights, but if you can, sweet. Just reach forward. Your job is a straight front leg and a straight back. When you're ready, pick up those weights. So I have my right leg forward. When I lift my arms, my right arm is also going to go forward. I am slowing these down. Good, so the leg that's forward is also the arm that's forward. Down and lift. Slow these puppies down. Good. At the bottom, I want you to feel that stretch. I want you to feel that rubber band get tense. Good. That rubber band called your hamstrings. Good. In this case, yes. At the top, we're just adding a little shoulder work. Good. There's a lot of momentum involved, so the shoulders aren't too intense. Good. But they're not helping either. Yes. Good. 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 I want you to take your pace. I would count it with you, but I don't want to push that timing. Good, that timing is yours. Good. Slowly down, up, and lift. Forward, up, and lift. Nice. We're working right into that hamstring right off the bat first thing in the morning. It's not the easiest thing for that hamstring to do. Good. Give me one more. Love it. We're going to keep those weights in hand. Or you can lighten the load if you want. We're gonna go back to that repeater. You're in position. Good. Arms are nominal. You can keep them behind your back. You can swing them like you run. Just be careful of that. Good, 30 seconds. Way back there with that back foot. Come on. Reach, reach, reach. Yes, good. So we are still in that same split stance, same side. Good. You know me in timing, I'm not gonna count much of the clock. Good, but I think I got this one. Good, good, come on, right leg. Yes, push. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Love it. Take those weights, put them on the floor. Did anybody grab a step stool or a chair? A chair would work, or nothing. Alrighty, I brought my own little step stool here. Good. So these are Bulgarian split squats. Good. The reason we elevate that back leg is so that we put the workload better onto the front leg. Good. We're going to start with just our squats. Good. So remembering, a squat is a knee bend. Good, it is not a hip bow. Good, it's about those knees bend. but you got to listen to them. They want you to hear what your need tells you. It tells you this is good enough. Then you stick with that. Good. If you've got a little more in you, good. You're going to reach the floor and grab a weight. Grab the other one. Set one down. Set one down. Up. Up. Down. And down. Good. So your body should be moving straight down and up. Whether you're picking up and setting down weights or you're holding them. You can also get rid of them. Good. Body weight only. Good, because body weight only is good. We add weights to class so that when we go to do body weight on a daily basis, it's easy. Good. Yes. Good. Up. Up. Good. Down and down. One more time. Pick it up. Pick it up. Set it down. And set it down. Good. Leave those right there. Hold on to your split stance. I want you to put both your hands on that front knee. Good. You're going to hold. You're going to do an isometric, a holding squat with that front leg. That back leg, you're going to pull that heel back to your butt. What? Yes. I want you to do a booty kick. Good. My step stool is moving. Good. Back. Back. Woo. Back. Back. Yes. I want you to feel that right hip really start to talk to you. Four more. Three more. Two. And one. That's good for the right side, guys. Good. All right. I want you to stand. Feet comfortably apart. And I want you to rock through those hips. Good. And I want you to take those knees. Maybe some hip circles. That right side's tired. All right. Let's go left. Ready? Left foot forward. Repeating knee pulls. Good. Remembering that your lunge isn't here, it's here. Good. 30 seconds. Let's go. I know, I didn't start right on time. Oh well, you're okay. It's the first round. Good. It's not tired yet. Good, good. So I'm doing body weight. Because it's a start, it's a warm-up, it's my first round. Feel free to add weight if it's what you like. Come on. Five, four, three, two, and one. Love it. Grab those eights. We're going to go back to those split deadlifts with a lateral and a front raise. Left foot forward. Just as far. Actually, let's put those weights on the floor. Ever pull a hamstring, it is no fun. Good. They don't heal quickly and they're very grumpy. So don't mess with them, especially early in the morning. Let's let that hamstring warm up. Good. Each time you bend forward, see how far your fingers will reach. Good. Make sure your back remains tall and extended versus flexed. Good. Awesome. When you feel ready, bend your knee and pick up the weights. Continue. Then continue with your deadlifts. Yep. All right. Left leg is out front. So when we raise the arms, the left arm will go out front. Now, honestly, I really want to go the other way to counterbalance it, but that's not what I'm doing today. I want this to be a challenge. Somewhat in the balance. Good, because it is never a bad idea to practice balance. And this is the best class. We do that stuff. Good, good. You got it. Reach, lift, reach, lift, reach. So on Wednesday, over at the college, we did 750 stairs. We walked them. Good. But we still did 750 stairs. Pretty good. We were all a little shaky afterwards. Good. Keep going. If you need to get rid of the weights, do it. the last person starts moving. Good, good. Although, is that accurate on Zoom? I don't know. Good, let's go. So remembering, we want a big split. We want to be low to the ground. Good, we want to be digging into that front hip. Remember, this is a four-part hip work, hip load. Good. Yes. Good, 10 seconds, come on. I know, I'm going like 40 seconds, you'll be okay. Good, good. And that's a wrap for that one. Let's take those weights, put it back on the floor. Here's that Bulgarian split. All right, body weight to start. Squat and lift. Good, so your weight would appear to be evenly distributed because you're moving straight down and up. You're not moving forward in your squat. You're moving straight down and up. Good, try and think about that. Try and look at what's on the floor, your foot, the weight. Good, make sure your head is not moving forward back. You want to drop straight down. Good, 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 take your time. Couple more. If you got it in ya, pick up those weights. One, two, set them down, and two. Good, so keep going. Find your movement. What movement works best for you? Good. If not picking them up, if that's too deep a squat, just hold them. But I will tell you that I like picking things up and setting them down because they are real life movements that we do all the time. Good. Whether we like it or not. Good. My son dropped a fork on my foot and it went straight down to the top of my foot yesterday. It was lovely. Good. I have 3 time bruises. Good. Down. But I had to get up off the floor and get that thing off my foot. Good. Good, good. Drop and lift. Good, let's go, let's go. 8, 7, 6. Make sure you're bending that back knee. When you keep that knee straight, you end up with a forward back movement versus down up. Last one right here. Nice. Good. Let's come on. Oh, I forgot. Don't let me forget. All right. No weights. Just body weight. We stay nice and low. We pull that back foot. Good. Pull heels to butt. Good. Because I'm a little bit afraid of my step stool. Good. And it works much easier that way. Heel to butt. Heel to butt. Your front leg should move very little. You will shift ever so slightly forward and back, but very little. Good, your job is to stay low. How low is your hip? How low is it okay for your hip to be? Good, let's go, 8 more. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Move it. All right. Leave those weights on the floor. Woo. Few hip circles. Good. Let's do a few straight squats just to kind of level things out. Body weight only. Good. It's kind of like putting Humpty Dumpty back together again. Good. It's a little crooked. 4 more. 4, 3, 2. Excellent. All right, so we're going to be on the floor and up for this next series. Double push-ups, down, two, up for 30 seconds. We come back up and we do tricep kickbacks. We're going to do 2, maybe 4 rounds of a few different things. So, find what works for you. If push-ups are not good for you, I want you to lie down on your back and fly. Not chest presses, but flies. Good. Otherwise, let's get into push-up mode. Double push-up, double down, and up. Keep some weights nearby so that you have them ready to go. All right, hands are nice and wide. Let's go, 30 seconds. Down, two, up. 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 Good. Two, up. Good. Yes. You have 10 seconds. That's 10 seconds from 30 that I started at. Good. Elbows go back. Remember, we are bent forward enough that we can get the elbows up to our shoulder height. Kick. Good. Kick. So from the beginning, I want you to just get the movement. The most important part of this movement is that those elbows straighten out the back at horizontal. Good. And if you want to really give yourself a challenge, don't let those hands come forward very far. Stop them at your hip. Stop them at vertical. Stop them just below your elbow. Good. So we take the range of motion from 180 to 90. Good. Back. Good. Back. Come on, hold that stomach and back nice and strong. Bend that front leg. I know it's tired. Four more. Three more. Two more. And one. Set those aside. One more set of double pump push-ups. Grasshopper style. Elbows close. Hands close. And come right down the side of your body. Good. Here we go. 30 seconds. Down, two, and up. Down, two, and up. Down, two, and up. Down, two, and up. Good. Two, push. Down, two, push. Yes. Come on. 15 seconds to go. And I really counted this time. Good. I really looked at the clock. Not cheating. Good. Down, two, push. Down, two, push. Down, two, push. And that's it. That's it. Come on back up. One last piece. Good. Long arm kickback. So we did tricep kickbacks and your shoulder kickback. Good. So we're back to that left leg forward so that we level out both sides. Stomach is strong. Bend that knee. Knee over the ankle. Good. We push. We push. We push. Good, good. Push. Yes. Push. That is it. Push. You got it. Push. Push. Awesome. Yes. Push. 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 Yes, yes. Eight, last set. Seven, good. Six, stomach strong. Have the posture of lower body. When it gets tired, you straighten out that leg. Keep it soft. Good. Two more. Two. I know my mind, that was two extra. Good, good, good. All right, we're gonna go with a heavy weight and a towel. I'm assuming you all have a towel, right? Keep a towel nearby. Grab your towel, you're gonna move this. You're going to grab a heavy weight in the other hand. This is a little bit like patting your head, rubbing your belly. Good. This is your challenge of the day. All right, I want you to take that towel arm. And I want it to be a long arm, so not here, out here. Circle with a little bit of tension. Don't hit the fan. Good. All righty. Good. Push. And release. Push, release. Push, release. Push. Good. I'm going to push the envelope on this one, aren't I? Good. So what I'm looking for, keep moving. I'm looking for a circular motion with one and a push, release with the other. So we want to keep them different. It's all in your head. You can do this. Good. Circle, reach, and down. Reach. I know it's crazy. Good. We'll go talk with this stuff. Good. Curl. I like to see what direction your towel is going. Good. Yes. Reach. Good. I want both shoulders to get tired in a different way. One is tired here. Good. This one's tired from the rotation. My shoulder's not happy with that. Good. Push. Yes. Push. Two more. Good. Momentum both helps with the curl, makes it a little easier, but it also adds a challenge. Good. At the end, right here. Good. It's harder here, easier here. Good. So there's a balance there. Yes, get a little leg movement in there. Good. Squat, 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 wide, together. Find your pace. Slow it down as you want. Good. I would say I'm almost never opposed to slowing things down. Good. Yes, you look good. Good, let's go last four. Four, three, two, and one. Set them down. Back to that crazy towel thing. One towel, one heavy weight. We start with the one that gets a little hairy. So we'll start with the towel. Get him rolling. I tend to like to go backwards. I don't know why, it just seems to work a little better for me. All right, free weight. Press and lower. Press and lower. Press and lower. Press and lower. I want to see that hand. Okay, so this is really funny. Bill, your weight is going in a circle. I love it. Push. Good. It's hard. Good. Circle. Good. Circle one arm, straight the other. Woo! I hope nobody's chewing gum. Good. Yes. All the way up. All the way down. All the way up. I want to see a nice straight elbow. Unless your ceiling prohibits. Reach for your ceiling fan. Reach. Good. Reach. Yes. So why is this functional? Because doing two things at a time is normal. Good. And working through it is good for you. Good. Give me four more. Yes. Three. Two more. Two. Love it. All right. Good. We're going to knee lifts. Knee lifts. Easy. Simple. Good. Curl. Curl. Yes. Good. Curl. 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 Yes. 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 Nice and easy. Legs are simple. Good. So here's an additional challenge for those knees. When you pull those knees up, tilt your pelvis, pull with your core. Good. Don't make it just about the hip flexor, but make it about your core. Close that space. Pull. Good. Pull that whole pelvic bone up. Yes. Two for one heel. Yes. Good. Good. Curl. Curl. Come on, I want you to feel your core with this. Curl. 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 Yes, let's go. Eight more. Eight. Seven. Six. Five. No more. Four. Three. Two. And one. All right, last piece. You ready? And we have one variable shoulder. But keep both weights in hand. Lateral raise. Lift. Lift. Nice. Old ankles. We're balancing out both sides. Make sure here that at the top, you're here. And not here. Not here. This is the chicken. Don't do the chicken. Don't do the wave. Okay? Straight up. Smile. Come back. There's a space between your teeth here. Lean. Good. Open and close. Open and close. Nice. Good. That's it. Yes. Give me four more. Four. Three. Two. Last one. Sweet. All right. One last bit. I'm going to go with light weights on this because I don't want to go crazy. We're going to do a little bit of that shoulder. So, with two sets of weights, go light. No more split stances. This one's together. We're going to lift. Good. And this will change. And that's why I want it to be light. You could probably do fairly heavy here, but I don't want it. Good. Want your knees together. Your hips down. Knees forward. Hips down. Good. Good, good. Let's just do four more here. Three more. Two more. All righty. Bring those hands, palms down by your hips. You're going to draw a snow angel. Over and back. An angled snow angel. Now I know that you can't see yourself. Good. But I want you to try and keep that a nice level. It's about a 45 degree angle, give or take. Open and close. Backside those shoulders. Upper middle traps. Make sure your shoulders are pushing them down from your neck. We have a tendency to shrug. Push those down. Good. Your arms can go up with your shoulders down. Give me two more. Two. Last one. Sweet. Alrighty. Nice job. I want you to grab every weight that you've got there with you. Unless you have like 15 sets of things. Let's go heavy. Oh, we're going to start with core. Good. We're going to start with lateral flexion. I hope that you're warmed up enough. I've got 12 pounds. 13 pounds. Good. I love these. They are effective. And they'll go with the other stuff we're doing. We're doing obliques today, guys. Woo, you're on your own for straight sit-ups today. Good. Soft knees. Soft knees. Remember, this is a movement. Good. That comes without flexion. Straight up. Soften the knees. Reach. Reach. Let the arms just hang. There's no need to lift them. Just let them hang. They're just along for the ride. Good. Reach. Reach. Make sure your shoulders and hips are over your ankles. Good. Your knees are out front just a little bit. Yes. Good. You ready? Let's do some doubles. One, two. One, two. There's something staying there for a second. Good. A second longer. That makes things a little more challenging. Reach. Two. Reach. Two. Reach. Keep those shoulders back. Nice soft knees. Good. Reach. Two. Reach. Two. Reach. Two. Reach. Give me a couple more. Reach, two, and reach. Good. Bring those weights up front. A quick little rotation. And we're going to get down on the floor and continue our obliques. How's that sound? All right. Weights can go away. Off to the sides. Grab something soft that your elbows and forearms will appreciate. All right. So, these can always be done with your lower leg resting on the floor. If you can handle doing both legs up, I say try it. We're going to do hip dips to start. So we drop the hip and lift it. Drop the hip and lift it. Drop and lift. As we drop that lower hip, the top knee bends ever so slightly. This is the point at which I see just arms up in the air. Good. Reach and lift. Drop and lift. Drop and lift. Good. Four more. Three more. Two more. Last one. Have a seat. Good. Let's be on our stomachs. On your stomach, on your forearms. We're going to be forearms. Good. Hands are in a triangle. Elbows are open. In plank. A forearm plank. I want your elbows open because your hips are going to rock and rock. So if you have like a little bent ball underneath your belly, you're going to roll over the ball, come up and over, and the other side. Good. One hip to the floor, other hip to the floor. I love these. There's so much good stuff going on here. There's rotation. There's lateral flexion with rotation. Good stuff. Keep that spine mobile. Yes, and strong. Good, draw that belly button in. Four, three, two, and one. Love it. Sweet. All right, let's go side two. On that elbow, your knee can be on the floor or you can be on both feet. Good, hip dips. Drop and lift. Drop and lift. Drop and lift. Drop and lift. Awesome, awesome. Keep going. I'm gonna change the music. Make it a little more pleasant. Hopefully you can handle my Chris Stapleton. Good. Yes. Good. Three. Two. And one. Sweet. All right, one more. Rainbows. Up and overs on those hips. Forearm plank with elbows wide. Find your comfortable position and then begin rotating. Remember too, when it comes to rotating, when it comes to any movement, make that movement small to begin. Make it bigger as your body warms up into the movement. Good, and into flexibility. Good. Can't get your hips to the floor, no worries. Just move that direction. Remember too, that one side is usually more flexible than the other. Good, so do not be surprised if you can reach one hip to the floor and the other one gets lost on the way. Good, hold that stomach strong. Come on, four more, three more. Two more, and one. Woo, baby. All right, knees back. Child's pose. Love this position. Good. All right, I'm gonna have you open up your knees. Okay, so your knees, your hips, knees are like a V. Good, and I want you to rock. Okay, I want you to move. Good, I'm finding personally that in my stretching, if I can do some mobility within the stretching or as I'm stretching, I do much better. So, hold those stretches, but move within them as well. Good, let's come back to the middle. All right, I'm gonna take that top, put it over my left knee. Good, this is one of those mobile stretches I love. All righty, this one's good. Here's the hip flexor, go. Sit back and gently, don't sit off the back, just enough to lengthen that front hamstring. Good, ready? Come back, hip flexor, deeper, deeper, deeper. Good, release. Pull, pull, pull. One more time. Good, one, two, three. Last one back. Two and three. Sweet, let's switch legs. Yes, there's some shoulder stretch here too. Anterior deltoids. Good, a little bit of the chest. Sweet. And then one more piece of this. Ready? That knee comes down. We reach across and we put our forehead on the back of our hand. Good. Come back center. Up and over. Reach across. Hand down. Forward to your hands. Good. Come back to center. Awesome. Two legs out front. Oh, we've done hamstrings, so we're good here. Arms up. Let's rotate. 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 Four more. Four. Three. Two. And one. I say we're done for today. Happy Friday. How'd you do? We're good. Sweet. All right. So we might get some winter weather this weekend. I decided I'm going to bake about a bazillion cookies and make my kids decorate them. I don't know. We'll see what happens.